Devon's Point, the southernmost of the six main stem dams in the Missouri River Basin. Construction on this 74-foot tall and 8,700-foot long dam began in 1952. Some 7 million cubic yards of earth fill and 308,000 cubic yards of concrete were used to complete the structure in 1957. Even though it's the smallest of the main stem projects, Devon's Point plays a critical role in regulating river levels throughout the lower basin, as it serves as the final gateway from the reservoirs in the Dakotas and Montana. Prior to the flood of 2011, the largest release from Devon's Point was 70,000 cubic feet per second in 1997. As June 2011 draws to an end, the structure is releasing 160,000 cubic feet per second, and it is performing optimally.
Devon's Point Dam is performing very well during this 2011 event. It is performing exactly as it was intended to. When we're passing these kinds of flows, we're more watchful of certain things. You know, our inspections of the spillway go up, our inspections of the dam go up. And between the earthen dam and the spillway and the power plant portion of this versus the dam, we are totally satisfied with the way the dam is performing right now.
Even though 160,000 cubic feet per second is a historic amount, it represents only a fraction of what the main stem project is capable of releasing.
Really, the flow that's going through Devon's Point Dam, 160,000 cubic feet per second, you know, is really what's appropriate for this flood at this point in time in 2011. Much higher water can be released from Devon's Point Dam, especially the spillway. Devon's Point Dam, including the spillway, can release a flow of 584,000 cubic feet per second in the event of an extreme flood event.
Thankfully, there are no plans or conditions at this time that would require higher releases. To find out more about Devon's Point or any of the other main stem dams in the Missouri River Basin, follow us on Facebook or Twitter.